What is up, guys? Mr. The Reverts here, and we are only 4 days away from the release of Call of Duty Black Ops 4, and today we got a bunch of information on when we can preload Black Ops 4, a possible prestige icon, and more. Now guys, this afternoon Treyarch made a post with a bunch of announcements which I'm gonna get into in a second here, but firstly within the post over on Twitter, they uploaded this image of what appears to be a prestige icon. I'm not sure which level it may be, but if I had to guess, I'd say it's somewhere between prestige 1 through prestige 5. To me, it kinda resembles like a little Renaissance knight helmet in a way. I love the green colors mixing with the gold and silver, so pretty cool looking icon we have here, and I'm pretty sure come this week we are gonna get all the prestige icons revealed to us slowly but surely. But now moving on to the update, guys, before playing for the first time, players are gonna have to download and install a day one update for Call of Duty Black Ops 4. This update must be installed completely in order for you to access multiplayer, zombies, and the specialist headquarters. I'm not sure what the specialist headquarters menu is, but if I had to guess, I say it's gonna be like the little mode that's gonna replace the campaign in a way. Like maybe here you can, you know, pick and choose a specialist character mission to play as, or maybe it's gonna be something like the headquarters from Call of Duty World War II, or maybe it's gonna be like a mix of both, I don't know, but regardless, we cannot access this mode along with multiplayer and zombies unless we download that day one patch update. Now, once the download has completed around 30%, then you can start to play Blackout. So again, once that update reaches the 30% level, then you can play Blackout and let the rest download to pass the time. The download is going to be coming in at 55 gigs, which isn't too bad, especially now since you can pre-download on your console at 12 a.m. on October the 10th for the console users. For the PC users, however, preloading is going to begin at 9 p.m. Pacific time on Tuesday, October the 9th, which is tomorrow. So if you can, try to stay up a little bit later, let the download run, get some sleep, and have it all ready to go for the 12th. I highly recommend pre-downloading because that way when you finally get the game, you can just play instantly without waiting for hours and hours for the update to install. Also guys, Treyarch is going to be posting a video to kind of recap all the changes made in Blackout and multiplayer. Plus, they say that we are planning to participate in some special launch time live streams, so that's something to kind of look out for come later this week. Now, if you are wondering about those players who got early copies, this can either be some good news or some bad news. It just kind of depends what side you're on. But if you have an early copy of Black Ops 4, sadly, you still are not able to play the game just yet. However, you can download that big update that I was talking about earlier, but you just cannot play yet because the servers are still not live. So, like I said, this is either bad news if you paid a lot of extra cash for a copy early because, you know, you still can't play. And I don't think servers are going to be going up until maybe Wednesday or Thursday, but this can also be good news because that way nobody gets an extra jump on leveling up and unlocking everything. So guys, that's the big update we got today. We're only 4 more days away from Black Ops 4. I'm so excited, guys. Make sure you check back onto the channel later this week for some more videos as we get ready for the Black Ops 4 season. And also post-launch, I got some amazing videos planned, like some tips and tricks, guides, and a whole lot more. Thanks for watching. I love you guys so much. Let me know your thoughts about the update and the prestige icon down below in the comments. Till next time, I'll see you guys later.